could explain it further. I wish it wasn't true. Celebrate the release of Happier Than Ever, I decided to paint this photo of Billie. I knew I wanted to paint this the minute I saw it, and it's a hard angle to paint, well, for me anyway. And I want to get better at portraits, so here we go. First, I had to paint the board with white acrylic, just so that the paint that I'd put on top would be a solid colour and would pop. Let's start with the playlist. First song is I'm in the Mood for Love by Julie London. Billie has mentioned her before, saying she was an inspiration for the album cover. However, this tune of the song sounds very familiar to Bossa Nova to me, which is personally one of my favourite songs on the album, so I thought it would fit perfectly. Once the paint is dried, it was time to start pencilling out Billie. I started with the top of her head, which would help me get a good idea of where to place the features. Some people might cringe at the fact that I'm starting with a silhouette outline, but for me this helps me see the image as a whole. I didn't really struggle with drawing out everything except her eyes. This will be explained a lot later and you'll see why. But because her face is on the side, it was hard to draw her eyes in the position that they were in and to get them proportionally accurate as much as I could. As you will see, the sketch isn't perfect right now, but it was a good starting point, and as I start painting, I can change things with the paint. And ta-da! Here is the initial sketch. I haven't drawn out any details, such as the flowers on her top or hair strands, as this will be added with paint. Does it look like her right now? Yeah, kinda. That will change later though. Okie dokie, it's time to start painting the background with this gorgeous rich dark green colour using a mix of these shades, Pathalo Green, Green Light and Light Green. What? While we make this colour combo, the second song of the playlist is Getting Older by Billie Eilish, of course. This song is a great mix of Billie talking about how she's potentially feeling, as well as relating to what other people are figuring out life for you. No, I related to some of the lyrics. The sound of the song is also very soothing, and this is a great song to wind down to. The song of the playlist is Daddy Issues by The Neighbourhood. Billie is a fan of The Neighbourhood, and I remember her talking about this song in an interview or something like that. Can't really recall, but this song opens with raw vintage sound of a guitar with a subtle backbeat. And again, this song gives me very similar vibes to NDA and a mix of the opening to Happier Than Ever, the actual song. It's a great song, and if you haven't listened to it already, I definitely recommend. It's the colour mixed for the background. Reason I'm starting with the background is because it'll be easier for me to paint the hair strands over the green. It does look slightly teal in the camera, but trust me, it was pretty much the exact shade of green as it was in the photo. Another song for the playlist, We Fell In Love In October by Girl In Red. Girl In Red is opening for Billie on tour in the US, I think? I can't really remember. But she's opening for her on tour, so we've got to appreciate her music. I don't know if this will make much sense, but it feels humbly made. Like, you know, it was like, it gives me the vibe that it was recorded in her bedroom or something like that. It's just really chill, it has a nice melody. Yeah. Now time for the skin. These are the shades I'm using. It's quite an autumnal colour palette looking at it now, but the most important colour was white in this process, since Billie has a very similar skin tone to me, you know, pale. It was a key ingredient, but not so pale where there was barely any colour, because I think Billie had a bit of a tan, more like of an olive toned her skin in this photo. And yes, I did accidentally film the first half in slow-mo, so go me for wasting a lot of time on the painting in slow-mo. Not gonna lie, I really struggled with the skin tone. It took me so many layers to get it as good as I possibly could. It was annoying because when I would remix the colour, it would be slightly off in tone, like it would have a more orange tone to it, so that meant I had to cover over certain areas because it would dry quickly. Yeah. The skin 100% took the longest, just like the section of the video. So time for our next song, Hayley's Comet. All I have to say is that this song feels like you're trapped in a daydream, but a good daydream. I feel I zone out when I listen to this song, but not in like a negative way, just like in a content way. It's quite dreamy. I just picture a scene of where space meets like Renaissance era. I see colours of cream, beige, light purple, dark blue, more of like a royal blue. That was really weirdly specific. Okay, but yeah, Hayley's comment, mwah, chef's kiss, honestly. Here's a quick skin update. Not looking good yet, but you've got to trust the process when it comes to painting. It's all about building up the layers. So before any of you say, it doesn't match, watch till the end of this video. then tell me what you think. But please be nice, this took me forever. Song number, I don't know, is California by Lorde. A new song from Lorde's album Solar Power. This is probably my favorite song from the whole album. I feel like I'm on a beach with this song, and it gave me a similar sound and vibe to what Billie's album has. I don't know what style of music you would call Billie's new album and Lorde's album, but I feel like there's this particular calming, chill sound which is very popular at the moment. I mean, I love it, but yeah, I'm just hearing it a lot lately. I don't know. I started painting the facial features of the nose and the mouth, and I'm really happy with how these turn out. And now looking at the eyes, watching this back with the skin done and the nose and the mouth completed, they look weird. Like, they look off, but I didn't notice this because they looked fine from the angle I was painting them. I don't know how I didn't notice how awful they were. Like, I'm embarrassed. So yeah, I did waste my time painting these, but then my dad thankfully stopped me in my tracks and said about how the eyes looked off.
Oh shit.
That is a wide of the face. It's too far away from the rest of it.
I can't unsee it now.
Yeah, exactly.
And can you guess what happened? I just went straight in with I just went straight in with white paint and covered that god-awful eye. I was a little annoyed because the eye took me so long to paint and like get the shadowing and all that done. But if I'd just taken a step back and noticed, then I wouldn't have wasted my time. Sorry. I need to just calm down. If you can tell, I'm a little bit triggered by that whole situation, but we're just gonna ignore that. So, as you can see, I did change the eye, I painted it, and this is what I came out with. This is so much better than the original, so I'm good now. I'm no longer angry. Okay, let's quickly fit in another song. Boom, Are You Even Real by James Blake. This has a little mix of everything, but it all goes really well together. It's got a beat, vivid instruments, beautiful melody, layers, just trust me and listen to it. Okay, time to move on to her shirt. I was nervous to paint this since I don't think I've ever really painted silk before. So this was new for me. I only needed three colors for the shirt, yellow, ochre, peach, and brown. This was the most satisfying to paint because it was on a bigger area, so I could be a little bit more carefree while painting the base. I also found it really fun to paint the shadowing and texture. It was something new for me, and I think I didn't do too bad of a job with it, if I do say so myself. Earthquake by Tyler, the Creator. Billie's mentioned her love for Tyler's music in the past, so I had to include him in this playlist. And this is the song I chose. And with really insane editing skills, I'm gonna make the shadowing and texture and all that look like it was done in 2 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh yes. Here is the finished shirt. I was really happy with how the shirt turned out. This is my first time painting material, mind you, and I feel like I was able to make it look like clothing. I think I did a pretty good job. So now it's time to move on to the detailing of her shirt. Now, I was a bit nervous for this because I didn't use a stencil. I didn't draw it out initially. I just went straight in with paint, drew on the flowers, and it was very satisfying and very therapeutic to paint, and I was really happy with the color match as well. The flower that was on her shoulder was actually quite easy to paint in terms of color because it was just a simple block of color and it didn't have too much depth to it. The real challenge came in when I had to paint a flower within the crease, and here's the reason why. So in the photo, Billie's wearing a silk shirt, which meant that the floral design on the shirt made of silk, but a shinier silk, so they kind of stood out from the shirt, but they were still the same color as the shirt. How many more times can I say shirt? So when it came to painting the flower that was in the crease, that was really hard because in the image the flower and the color of the shirt are literally the exact same shade, so I had to kind of like distinguish the difference so people could actually see the floral design. Overall, I think I was able to make it look pretty realistic and silky and have the lighting that it would be in real life if it was creased. That was definitely the most challenging part. So yeah, that was the process of the shirt, and I think it turned out well. And now it is time for the final big step of this painting, which is the much anticipated hair. I started with laying down a block of colour initially, which was a very light yellow. This will help later on with layering, and any spots I don't fully paint strands on, you won't even notice. So drawing hair with pencil, I think I'm quite good at, but with paint, it was actually harder than I expected, because you really don't know how many different shades, layers, different lighting and shadowing that is actually involved with something like hair. Looking at the chunk of hair I did on her shoulder with the overall image, I think I needed to move it up a little so it was almost touching her chin. So that was a proportional error on my part, but you wouldn't really notice this if you were just looking at the painting on its own and not comparing it. So it doesn't bother me too much, so it's okay. Let's talk about another song, Female Energy Part 2 by Willow. And quick story time, there's this song called Wait A Minute, which I adore, I play it so much. Anyway, I saw it was by Willow, but I didn't know that Willow was Will Smith's daughter. You know, like whip my hair, Willow. It just never occurred to me. And I was actually mind blown when I found out that she sang it. It just sounds completely different to the girl who sang Whip My Hair. I know she's grown a bit older now, but yeah, I just thought I'd share that anyway. But yeah, Willow's music is really good and her voice is amazing. So I definitely recommend you go check her out. This hair took me a very long time, as you can see with this small section that I'm working on now. To complete that, it took me about 3 hours just for that small section. Okay, maybe 2 hours without distractions. But that just shows how much time these paintings actually take. Here are 3 more songs to add to the playlist. We have Brooklyn Baby by Lana Del Rey, Electric by Alina Baraz featuring Khalid, and Bitches Broken Hearts by Miss Eilish. Since this video is about music as well, follow me on Spotify. It'll also be linked down below so you can see what I've been listening to, and you will also be able to find the playlist. So the video where I did, oh, aesthetic songs you should have on your playlist, I've got that playlist actually on my Spotify. So go ahead and follow me on Spotify. I think in total, this painting took me about 16 days, which I don't think is too long for how detailed this painting is. We are now moving up onto the middle section of her hair. I feel that this certain chunk of hair was quite important to get as accurate as I could, because this is one of the main features of her hair. I found it quite hard to get the shadowing like perfect and the colour. Right, I know her hair is like a really like light blonde, almost kind of platinum blonde in a way, but I found it so hard to colour match it to where it looked real. Because when I did the light yellow colour strands, it just looked weird. It looked like cheese string. So yeah, I found it really hard to make it look as natural as possible. So that wasn't very fun. But I do think I managed to get it almost accurate as the time went on. Overall, I think her hair should have been a little bit lighter, just because Billie's hair is so blonde now that I don't think it had as many dark tones as I put in there. But with the shadowing and stuff, I'm pretty proud of. And this was actually my first time painting like really detailed hair. So I'm really proud of myself and I'm really happy with the outcome. Finally, to finish off her hair, I had to paint the top half of her head. And I actually found this quite tricky because she had almost like a gray shadowing on her hair. The lighting was weird because she had like a gray almost block on the top of her head in the photo. But that was like the reflection because her hair's so shiny. So yeah, this was really hard to capture correctly because sometimes I got it a little bit too dark, sometimes it looked blocky and I needed to incorporate a few more of the blonde strands through it. I think I was able to capture it as best as I possibly could. The thing that made this hair seem the most realistic to me was adding the strands of hair coming up the top of her head. Like adding the little flyaways, that just made the hair feel a lot more realistic to me. If I hadn't have added those flyaways, the hair would have been just as good, but I just feel like it wouldn't have looked as lifelike as it would have with the strands. I found it quite annoying painting her fringe because the hair colour was quite similar to her skin tone. So you couldn't really see the strands, so they kind of blended in. So I had to make them a little bit more of a different tone so you could actually see them. But when they were all in place, this did actually take me a while. This took me about an hour and a half to do. But with it all in place, I was really happy with the overall outcome. And to finalise this painting, I finished off little details around that I just thought needed cleaning up. Maybe I could redo to make them better. So I added eyelashes on her second eye because I realised I forgot to do that. Did like the detail of the button on her shirt, and I also added her pearl necklace. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the grand reveal of the Happier Than Ever Billie Eilish painting that took me about 2 weeks and a bit to complete. This is the end result. I am really happy with how this turned out. I found this really challenging. Like, I didn't think I was going to find it too hard. I just looked at it and I was like, this is going to be okay. Like, I don't think I'm going to struggle too much. If anything, it was more the colour matching for me that I really struggled with. Her skin took absolutely forever. It just took the longest, and I did not expect the skin to take that long. I should have known that from my large painting that I did, because the skin on that took way longer. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about my pros and cons for the outcome. Let's start on a positive note. So, first pro, I'm really happy with how the hair turned out. I think it looks quite realistic, and I feel I was able to capture like the different shadowing and detail and like the depth of the hair. And that's my first time painting hair, so I think I did quite a good job. Second pro, I am so happy with how the shirt turned out. I think the shirt is actually my favourite part, besides the hair. I've never painted like a silk-like texture before. It doesn't look fully silk, but I've never painted material before, and I think that turned out really well. Another pro is the nose and the mouth, to be very specific. I really like my shadowing and how I did the nose and mouth. The nose looks very realistic. I'm very proud of the nose. Mouth as well, I really like how that turned out. Them two as a pair are probably some of the best facial features I've done. Maybe not the lips, but the nose, one of the best. So yeah, that really made me happy. Now let's move on to the cons. I'm not going to be too negative because I did this painting freehand. Like, I didn't really measure any proportions. A few things are a little proportionally inaccurate, which would matter if you're comparing them side by side. On its own, you may not be able to tell overly, but when you compare the two, there are some proportional inaccuracies on my part in the terms of I should, you know, be more accurate and actually like do the math. Whenever there's math involved, I just ignore it. I don't give it a second look. Her eyes, right. I like how the main eye looks, the one on the side of her face, like with all the eyeshadow. I really like how that turned out in the end. Initially, was awful, but the final result, I'm really happy with. The eye that's like facing inwards, which you can't really see very well, it looks weird. It does look a bit funny. Like, altogether it looks okay, but individually, yeah, I definitely think I could have done that better. Third con, I don't like how I did the shadowing under her chin. It kind of looks like she's got a little bit of a beard. This took forever and I kind of just gave up in the end. I am overall happy with the outcome. Could I improve on it? Yes, there's definitely areas that I could have done better, but you know, I don't want to tear myself down too much. And there you go. That was my Billie Eilish Happier Than Ever portrait that I painted. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me out a lot. Very, very close to 1,000 subscribers. So it'll make me really happy. That's all I have to say. Thank you all so very much for watching. And I will see you next week, hopefully, with a brand new video. Bye.